Hi, everybody. It's the red hot Eric Medlen here at Pomona. This week on the Medlen Diaries, I'd like to talk about funny car fires.
Not going to happen for Ed because it's Eric Medlen doing it again. 4.91 seconds, 300 miles an hour.
You know, it's kind of a big deal from the outside, inside. Just get that mother stopped and get out and plug old AAA for the insurance that's going to pay for this Syntec Mustang.
I love that Eric Medlen. I'm seeing him and his dad work so good together. Bottom line, the kid's showing his stuff. He's driving like a pro, and I'm really proud of him.
He was the lead guy for my next generation of drivers. I've only met a few in my lifetime that just loved to drive a race car that much that he would drive for free. It's not about money. He just loved it.
Trophy. I'm going to give it to his dad. Kid was the greatest driver, all hard of all time. I just loved him. And like he'd say today, Force, quit your whining, get out there and hurt some feelings. Eric Medlen, I know you're watching me. You beat up the lead.
No matter where you wander in this vast racing complex, there are constant visual reminders and remembrances and tributes to Eric Medlen, be it decals on race cars, be it special commemorative t-shirts, special signs, even commemorative wristbands that we're all wearing in tribute to the memory of this man and in support of his family and John Force Racing.
We're evaluating what happened to Eric in his crash, and we're going to turn that into a life-saving circumstance for the drivers in the future.
But Force's son-in-law, Robert Height, carried the torch for Team Force all the way to an emotional winner's circle.
I'm not going to mention any sponsors today because Eric used to do that for everybody enough anyway. But I want to tell you about the people I work with, John Force, Eric Medlen. When I won Indy last year, I got back and John kept saying, "You won Indy, all right." He says, "I hope someday Eric can win Indy." And then, you know what? Eric did more than win Indy. He made everyone around him happy and smile. That's a true champion.
Right after Eric's accident, John stopped all competition on all the cars. He said, "We have got to find out what we can do to protect the drivers better." So we made some changes, missed a race, widened the roll cage, came up with a much, much improved padding scenario, and introduced all that into the cars. Well, in John's accident, that padding was in place, and his accident, the damage to the chassis was actually quite a bit more severe than Eric. His tire failure wasn't of the same type because the sidewall of the tire did not come off the rim and create the oscillation that Eric's car saw. But nevertheless, the car broke in two, similar to Eric's, and whether it was divine intervention, the car just landed exactly in the only place it could land to preserve both arms and legs.
Force credits the safety changes his team and John Medlen instituted following the death of Eric Medlen for saving Force's life.
We're not going to let Eric's life be spent in vain. His life's going to count for something, and it's in the safety of that race car. It's up to us to make sure that happens.